Thomas Markle is begging his daughter to let him hold her baby at the christening. A close friend of the Duchess of Sussex's father revealed, Thomas has said he just wants one final chance to make things up with Meghan. He can't bear the thought of not being able to hold his new grandchild. Whatever it takes, that's what he wants. Mr. Markle, 74, missed out on Meghan's wedding to Prince Harry, but is hoping they can make up in time for him to attend the baby's christening, due in April. His friend said, he celebrates his 75th birthday in August and he can't think of a gift he would rather have than to be able to cradle the baby. Mr. Markle is more out of favor with Meghan than ever, after publicizing a poignant letter she sent him last year. It opened with the words, "Daddy, it is with a heavy heart that I write this, not understanding why you have chosen to take this path, turning a blind eye to the pain you're causing." Meghan berates Mr. Markle repeatedly, insisting she and Harry did all they could to help him, even after he pulled out of their wedding on May 19. She also blasts the ex-Hollywood lighting director, who lives in the Mexican seaside town of Rosarito, for giving media interviews. But his friend said, he had such a strong relationship when Meghan was growing up and he wants that back without these endless back and forth squabbles. He believes life's too short and would dearly love to hold her child and meet her husband. He hopes she can find it in her heart to forgive him for everything she feels he has done wrong. Meanwhile, security experts have voiced fears Mr. Markle is a sitting target for kidnappers because his hilltop home is less than 14 miles from the crime-ravaged border city of Tijuana, where a record 2,518 people were murdered in 2018. His pal said, "There is no question it's getting more dangerous for him to be here. But what can you do? There's no way he can afford to sell up and move back to America." The royal couple had been pinning their hopes on moving into the Windsor mini mansion before Meghan gives birth to their first child in a few weeks. But builders renovating the former workers' homes are still landscaping the grounds and laying pipes and power for the 50,000-pound Zico boiler. And work on the roof barely seems to have started. The royal couple had even booked Meghan's place in the maternity wing at nearby Frimley Park Hospital, Surrey. A Kensington Palace spokesman refused to comment on the delay or Meghan's chosen hospital, but one friend said, "It is a blow. They wanted to start their new life as parents in their own family home. There's nothing they can do but wait." Harry and Meghan were given the Grade II listed cottage by the Queen and friends say they cannot wait to move out of Kensington Palace. They currently live in the two-bedroom Nottingham cottage, in the palace grounds. They also live side by side with Harry's big brother Prince William and wife Kate, and a friend of the Sussexes confided, they want to be on their own. Harry and Meghan's £3 million taxpayer-funded plans for their new home meant a complete interior rebuild. As well as a mother and baby yoga studio, there will be a palatial staircase, new fireplaces, and state-of-the-art kitchens. It will also have the toughest security of any royal residence.